Today's modern telescopes from manufacturers like Skywatcher, Meade and Celestron need power. A stable power supply is essential to an efficient operating of their typical go-to systems. And we're going to take a close-up look at some of the options available to you to power your telescope. Probably the simplest is a mains power supply. We're looking here at an AC 317 by Astro Engineering. This plugs into the mains and terminates in a 2.5mm hollow point jack. That's supplying 12 volts. So this will do for powering things like Meade ETXs, especially the Maksutov Cassegrain types. This will also do for most of the Skywatcher telescopes, as well as most of the Celestron models on the market as well. A lot of Skywatcher and Meade telescopes are equipped with this kind of thing, a small battery box and a power cable. And again, be careful of running this type of device with NiCads. We'd strongly recommend you use just good quality, fresh alkaline batteries when using this type of power supply. Be wary of the NiCads because they typically undervolt. And the sophisticated CPUs in some go-to telescopes actually won't function correctly if they undervolt. So if they find batteries with less than 1.5 volts in them, there's a possibility of them actually failing. Independent battery systems come in a number of octane grades. The two that we've got on show here are manufactured by Skywatcher. We'll start with the smaller of the two here, which is 7 ampere hours. It's got some quite nice features. Quite heavy, but nevertheless actually easily portable. Got a very substantial lamp on the front of it there. You get a tan off that if I actually pointed at Drew there. Got a nice little red light as well. That's quite nice for setting up your equipment and not spoiling your night vision. Also flashes as well with a second press of the button there. We've also got 3 volts, 6 volts and 9 volt output power supplies. The 9 volt one there could be quite useful for powering things like the ETX 60, 70 and 80 telescopes. It's fitted with 2 cigar lighter sockets, so anything that is powered by a cigar lighter can be plugged into there. We're using an Astro Engineering cable there, an AC367, as an ideal way of powering Meade and Skywatcher telescopes, as well as a lot of the Celestrons as well. That's also got an overall on and off switch there, so you can make sure that everything is off just by throwing that switch at the top there. On the rear of the device, we've got a couple of banana socket takeoff points. No specific astronomical use for that, but it might come in handy. We've also got the charging system running it from a cigar lighter socket hidden away in a little packet, a little pocket at the back there, which is quite useful. The red lens, incidentally, actually comes off the top there, and it actually gives you a second lighting option. So we've got another white light, not quite so ferocious as the main light on the front there. That's 7 ampere hours. So basically that'll power a 1 amp telescope for 7 hours solid, is the way to think about that. Plenty of power on this one at 17 ampere hours. Again, that'll run a 1 amp consuming telescope for 17 hours. Look, plenty of features again as well. We've got that same very bright, powerful front light there, as well as the red setup light on the front there, quite useful for setting up your telescope. Also with the flashing option. Fully fused to protect your equipment as well, which is a useful feature. We've got that same 3, 6 and 9 volt output option. Can't really see the need for this for something like the ETX 60, 70 and 80. It really would be a little bit over the top, I think, for it. We've got the same shuttered cigar lighter socket output points there, quite useful. And nice feature on this one, we've got a FM radio. Rather nice to listen to while you're out observing. Quite a nice feature, and you see, depending on what your tastes are. Around the back of the unit, we've got a little hidey hole for the mains power supply system, and you can also recharge this from a car battery cigar lighter socket as well. That's all squirreled away in the back there. And if you get to your car after a night's observing and it won't start, you've even got these high power jump lead features that will allow you to put 250 amps instantaneously onto your car battery. And there you have it, a range of options for powering your telescope.